Hey, what's up? It's promo guy Ian Skinner here. That's Cat's Yuri Shibata. It's a picture. You probably want to listen to the video version or like watch and listen. Use your eyes and your ears to enjoy this podcast episode. But if you're listening on the audio version, I'm pointing at a picture of Cat's Yuri Shibata that my friend made for me. I've got this world's worst mustache going on right now. There's a whole bit that will pay off like this weekend when I'm recording this, but by the time like an episode's out, like you'll be like, oh, it's just bad. Oh, you're listening to the SWN podcast, where Scottish wrestling lives, I guess. Is that a tagline? I guess, I don't know. Buy my merch.
Never will I be in that situation again. I'll never be in that situation again. I would never, ever recommend putting Vicks Vapor Rub on your eyebrows while canoeing. And that being said, I understand you've got a few questions for me this evening. And I also I dress for the occasion. Yeah? You know, when the tux comes out, Billy. Let's do this.
Okay, right. Welcome to the SWN podcast. I am your host, as always, Billy. I am joined by a very interesting guest. This is the epilogue of season 6 because I panicked and got new guests on as the season ended, and I'd already put out a t-shirt for 6 seasons and a t-shirt. Anyway, I'm your host, as always, Billy.
Six.
So this is the epilogue, season 6 on tour season, and I'm joined by a very interesting fellow that I'm going to be speaking to, a guy that people have been clamoring for to have onto the podcast. He is suited, he is booted, he is ready to go. It is the one, possibly only, Frank Gallo. Welcome to the show.
Finally! This has been a long time coming, Billy.
A very long time, because I was doing my research, as I always do on these podcast episodes, and I went right back to the start, right back to the nucleus of Frank Gallo.
Nucleus!
And I saw a promo about Student of the Month. And unfortunately, I tried to watch as many promos as I could, and I missed this one at the time. And the first thing you mentioned about being Student of the Month, it wasn't picked up at any outlets, anyone at all, not even Scottish Wrestling Network. And immediately I thought, oh no, I've missed out on the opening floor, the first rung of Frank Gallo, by missing out on Student of the Month.
Well, in your defence, the East 5 Mail didn't pick it up either. And that was the publication that I was particularly interested in. Not to discredit SWN, because I've been a big fan for a long time. But no, it wasn't picked up on. And actually, Student of the Month morphed. It morphed and morphed, and it changed. It changed into Student of the Year. I was the only Student of the Year for FPWA. Now Power Pro! So, that's where that story begins and ends.
Creating history wherever you go, Frank Gallo, by being the one and only FPWA Student of the Year. That's, you know, 1 year in.
Billy, I've got a low network bandwidth message that's popped up. And I lost the audio for a second, but you're back.
That just adds to the excitement. Adds excitement to the episode because so have I. So I could freeze at some point. You could freeze at some point. This is the mystery. This is why this is the epilogue. It's the exciting end to the season where we just something happens. We don't know.
Sub-zero temperatures, Billy.
That's it. Between the high temperatures of our respective thermometers through illness and the low temperatures outside, somewhere in the middle. The internet says, they're working. No, I'm not going to do that.
I've had a heavy bout of scarlet fever. I've been travelling. I was on the continent, and then I went elsewhere, and I picked something up along the way on my travels. But, thankfully, I seem to be coming out the other side, so we're all right.
We'll make it through. Well, by the time this episode comes out, we'll all be nice and healthy and ready to go. So, speaking of being a fan of a long time, what was the moment that you saw the wrestling on the TV or in your life they decided to go, you know what? I want a piece of this. I want to dedicate part of my life towards this goal of being a professional wrestler.
The squared circle, eh? Eh? Professional wrestling. So, tell me a wee story. I stumbled upon it quite by accident as a small innocent child. Young Frank, blessed with the name Frank, may I add, which means free man. And I freely discovered professional wrestling probably somewhere along the road in about 1992-ish. Yes. So, from there I was hooked.
Right,
Billy, can I ask you, what was your first year of wrestling? Huh?
My first year was 99, I think.
Good year. Good
year. Oh, yeah. My first memory, I've said it many times, my first memory was seeing, although I think I have to remove some names after the news of the last couple of weeks, someone's redacted teddy bear getting set on fire by The Undertaker. That was my first ever memories of the professional wrestling. And somehow, as an 8-year-old, thought, yeah, why not? Let's have a bit of this in my life forever by seeing a grown man set something on fire.
Well, sometimes we can be drawn to the macabre. Yeah, I understand. I totally understand.
So 92 then. Who was the guy? Who was the one?
Hitman! That... Bret Hart.
92, Bret Hart. So that's still Hart Foundation time, or is it? No. I was an IC champion.
No. Bret was on the ascent. Had his SummerSlam main event against the British Bulldog.
Of course. Can I forget?
Then he began to climb a wee bit further until he managed to unseat the Nature Boy. So yeah, I was glued. Glued!
Was it the colours? Was it the shapes? Was it just the... Bret Hart's one of those guys where I didn't get at the time because I wasn't ready. I wasn't ready for Bret Hart. But going back and watching it now and seeing his brain work, the psychology of a match, watching him pick apart a body part just to make it work. Is that something that Frank saw and thought, I'm going to make sure that I keep an eye on a limb? That's the target. Was there a bit of Bret Hart in your wrestling now?
Absolutely. You hit the head on the nail on the head. It's all about the body part. You pick a body part and you attack, 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 attack. And yes, I would have to say my exposure to the Hitman as a young child probably made me adopt the same strategy as a full-grown wrestler. I'm trying my best to implement that strategy now. How successful that is, sometimes it's hit, sometimes it's miss. But that's more down to me, Billy. That's about my feelings as a wrestler. But look, one can only strive to improve.
Bret Hart wasn't winning all his matches in his first year, I'm sure. Well, he might have been, but we don't know. Cage match has not been updated accordingly, despite my banging on about it. From that point onwards, then, I'm thrown out all over the place here. So, Hitman, that's a big gap between 92 and 2019-ish when we found out about Frank Gallo. Fill the gaps here. Was there a sport? Was there underground boxing? What was the life of Frank Gallo during that period?
The life of Riley, Billy. I had a few gap years. Let's put it that way. Probably best not touch on that missing time.
Okay, well, we'll move on and just leave the mystery to everyone else to fill the gaps.
I don't know if I can legally disclose my whereabouts over that period of time. Ha!
Well, okay, then that's fair enough. We'll definitely move on. So we do find out about you is like I say, student of the month, FPWA, now Power Pro. What drew you to Andy Roberts? It would have been Wild at the time, but now he's Roberts.
Yes.
Going about. So was he a guy that you had seen? You'd seen him in the wilderness. Where was Andy Roberts in this story?
So I knew that the asylum, the Fife Pro Wrestling Asylum, was due to open. I started training for a couple of months prior. W3L. Trained there for a month or two. The asylum was going to be opening its doors. And it seemed as though, Billy, that would be the perfect place for me to hone my craft. When it comes to my mentor and coach, Andy, his resume, as they say in the States, speaks for itself. And look, I was somebody who wanted to hone my craft and learn the ropes, the wrestling business. Who better to learn from than, well, I mean, look at his accomplishments, his achievements, the tenure. Yeah, I mean, there's gravitas behind what he's achieved in the wrestling business. Who better to learn from? Eh?
Absolutely. And the staff, the coaching staff there as well, a guy that you would have been familiar with when you joined would have been Johnny Lyons as well, who's a little bit on the edge himself when it comes to speaking to him. So that must have been a match made in heaven when you came up with Johnny Lyons.
Fantastic coach.
But I feel like there was a story there just on the cusp, but that's okay. Well,
hey, what more can I say? I mean, look, Johnny Lyons, legendary career. I've just seen him wrestle his last ever match. I appreciate that man. He's taught me a lot. He's taught a lot of people a lot. And testament to his skills, we'll see that over the next few years because he has a great hand in training some young up-and-comers. And he has done for years and years and years and years and years. We're going to see the fruits of Johnny Lyons' labour continue to blossom for years and years to come.
So we'll move on there. Oh, sorry. Now I'll give you a big pause. I'm interrupting you. What a rude host I am.
Not at all. William, it was really nothing. It's okay.
So we'll go to where people will probably have got to know or been exposed to Frank Gallo in a legal sense of the word. Would have been your Discovery Wrestling debut against the Joe Henry School in that pre-show six-person tag team match.
Indeed.
A big night, big promotion, because it's Discovery Wrestling, one of the biggest promotions in Scotland. A big place to debut in. Did you feel prepared? Were you ready? Did Andy give you all the notes you needed to battle Joe Henry's trio?
Well, to be honest, first thought when it comes to mind, when I consider that match that night, hashtag blessed as the youngsters say these days. To be in that situation, to be in that match, really interesting because there are two people that my path has crossed here and there. There are two people that I seem to be intrinsically linked with over the years. So we've got Ryan Richards, we've got Tommy Cartel. Tommy Cartel and I worked together that night. Ryan Richards was on the other side of the ring. Was I equipped? Well, I guess we won that match. So yes, I would say so. However, this was six wrestlers starting out. I believe it was some other people's first match as well. The pressure was on. We had to represent for the school. And yes, big night for FPWA.
And like I say, you won it. So debut ticked off, big win, Frank Gallo. Moving on to our guy that's really intrinsic to paths you cross right now, other than Tommy Cartel, Ryan Richards. Next one's Thatcher Wright. There's another one that popped up quite a lot when I was doing my old notes here. When you debuted, it was September 22. There's a big gap between November 21, 2021, 2022. I don't know if I need to know the whereabouts of you, if it was just training, getting ready for the next battle. But this was FPWA Truth against Thatcher Wright. Again, big night for FPWA at the time. Well, keep explaining it. It's about now Power Pro. But FPWA, big night for them at Truth. Big night for yourself as well. Okay, how do you feel when it comes to that pressure? I mean, at the moment, it seems to be working out just about every time for you. There's a couple blotches on your win-loss record here, but
Yeah.
How do you deal with that pressure?
Well, if we think really specifically about that first show that we did at Truth, that was the first time I'd ever wrestled in my hometown or close to it. That's right. He's a Tory. And I have no politics, if I'm completely honest. I operate outside of politics. Politics doesn't interest me. As I said earlier, I'm a free man. However, Thatcher was operating in a former mining town, historically. So it seemed like a match made in heaven or hell, depending on your perspective. Fantastic wrestler, person, I don't know. But pressure was on, Billy. The pressure was on.
As a free man, though, do you class Bethel as, do you have a hometown, or is that just the place where you spent your formative years?
So, born and bred in Methil, live from Methil Docks right now.
Fair, that's fair. So we do know in that time, that big gap that we're not going to talk about, you're definitely a Methil. That's all we need to know. That's all the truth we'll gather from that moment.
Billy, the red fabric of life sometimes presents mystery. Sometimes it presents more questions than answers. But that's sometimes the beauty of it all, isn't it? If we were to answer the questions to all the great mysteries, what would we have left?
That's it. Podcast, the world be over. Some people might,
it might
prefer. But in the meantime, we're still here. We're gonna try and solve life's problems. We might not.
Yes.
But
we can try.
We'll certainly give it a go. So the next note I've got is girders. So looks like you're yeah. getting about. Everyone's finding out about Frank Gallo, and do you think it was a case of because you're presenting yourself freely and fully, that people are just wanting to find out a little bit about, like I'm trying to do now, find out a little bit more about Frank Gallo, so they need to take you to these towns and take you to these shows, these promotions, because everyone wants to find out what is Frank Gallo.
Well, Billy, I mean, I'll be honest, I don't consider myself to be that particularly interesting. And by the way, I feel honoured that you know, you've invited me on this show. I'm honoured. Just as honoured as I am to be, you know, involved in shows in places like Iron Girders. I feel particularly lucky that people are even interested. So, look, it's quite meaningful for me to be on this show. It's meaningful for me to go to places that I've not been before. And I genuinely appreciate it. So yes, Iron Girders, that was a strange and successful evening. I really enjoyed it. It was a fantastic experience. I was in the presence of some excellent wrestlers. I was in the presence of Wolfgang that evening. So yeah, I felt very fortunate.
That's the note I've got. I've got about Wolfgang in a very rare post-NXT appearance. You don't see Wolfgang appear at Girders quite a lot, and he was there, separating, helping you. Well, I say helping, part of an army to separate some FPWA stars and some IGPW. I'm getting confused with all the names here. FPWA and our Girders names. So it was quite a big scuffle to be part of, and big Wolfgang being right in the middle of it. A big feature in Scottish wrestling, and now he's. He's in the US, just tearing up as well. Hopefully, possibly joined by Frank Gallo in the near future. Who knows?
Look, I just have to say, again, really fortunate to be in that situation. Gentlemen, I mean, looking back, casting my mind's eye back the way, and thinking about that night, I felt very lucky to be there. Beautiful.
Speaking of beautiful, it must have been super satisfactory. Talked about Ryan Richards. I'm rattling through my timeline here, so we're gonna have a lot of time to go through some questions from the Instagram, what have you. You ended Ryan Richards' VIP streak at Discovery Wrestling. That must have been a very satisfactory night for old Frank.
Yes, yeah, it was. So, Ryan and I seem to be quite diametrically opposed. We couldn't be more different. He was born with somewhat of a, say, a silver spoon on the nice side of town. So, yeah, really different. Talent. Super talented. Can't take that away from him. But, yes, that was my night. And that meant, Billy, that I earned my space in the disco derby last year.
Hard to say, because you've made a couple of appearances for Discovery off the back of that particular moment, including the derby. As a promotion, like I said, as I mentioned, it's one of the biggest promotions in Scotland, I would certainly say. And to be into that roster and used regularly in that roster. You must be thinking, what, you're a year, 2 years into from training into actually being in the ring. That must be a huge feather in your cap if you're going through the logic, the logistics of your wrestling journey.
Absolutely. An ostrich feather. That's a big feather.
Yes.
And very it's big not feather. Lost on it is not lost on me. The opportunities that I've been afforded for whatever reason. Look, in these situations, Billy, my job is to work as hard as possible and try and win. And the very fact that I've been given the forum to express myself in front of these audiences, it feels good. It feels really really good, to say the least.
I mean, your standout, because you're such a standout, because of your free man, you're not afraid to just be yourself in front of an audience. They're excited to see you as well. That rapport bounces back. It's seen you land in title match and plenty of them as well, at Community Pro, at Fair City as well. And as someone who's, they say that there's a big gap in your history that we're definitely never going to get into, but it must be nice to have that crowd, that groundswell of support, that when you're put in these positions, they're very happy. Just, it doesn't matter, new audience, returning audience, they're all supporting Frank Gallo. That must be a very humbling thing.
Billy, it is humbling. These people are compassionate, beautiful people. I seem to run across these people across the country in different venues. And look, anybody who's shown any kind of appreciation for me, that hits old Frank right in the old ticker. Deep down in there. It feels really nice. So I just want to do whatever I can do to keep these guys happy. Because it's nice to be nice. Huh? It's nice to be loved.
And you are, Frank. I think of whenever I put out requests for getting people on this podcast, there's a couple of names that come out every so often. I've thankfully got quite a few of them on. Your name is always seems to be one that comes across my virtual desk of going, go get this guy on. And it's always a case of, right, I want to time it right. I want to make sure that I've timed it so we're both ready, willing, and able. And unfortunately, I'm not very able, but we're gonna manage to do this, because
Billy, you make me blush for a start. Secondly, you're doing a fantastic job. I would never know that you're feeling slightly under the weather.
It's because I'm naturally very pale. It works out well.
Me too, Billy. See when the moon's out. I burn.
That feels cruel to laugh at. I apologize. Oh, so sorry. But yeah, I mean, I kind of feel the same. Bald head, you know, it's a danger out there.
You and I are cut from the same cloth, my man.
I like to stay inside. I like to be a robe, or housecoat, however you want to call it. That's the kind of material I am. I like to stay inside. That's
A robe,
that's me.
good lad. Yes.
Robe's correct. For anyone who says housecoat, you're wrong.
Indeed.
So before we look into the future and then get into our Instagram questions, there is one match that I have to talk about before we go forward. You wrestled quite across Scotland. Yeah, like I say, it's a fair city, down into England as well for Mega Slam.
Yeah.
But one match that we have to mention is fighting for the United European. Oh God, I've got it wrong. United European Wrestling Alliance. Oh, I never write this down because I usually remember it. But UEWA, European
UEWA!
Heavyweight Championship.
Yeah.
You fought Andy Roberts for the title close to home. What a night that must have been. Again, especially considering how early into, well, hopefully early into your wrestling journey it is to wrestle someone of the stature of Andy for that title, who's got big history behind it. Just talk us through it. What was your thoughts, memories, feelings, emotions?
Billy, there's not many moments, not any moment so far in my wrestling career that have been as meaningful as that night. I was close. I was close. By the end of the day, you're in the ring with someone who is top of their game, top tier, in the middle of maybe the most remarkable title reign in European history, quite possibly. I can't really express how deep my feelings are and run when we talk about that match. I was very fortunate to have been given the opportunity by merit of the people of Leaving Truth Nightclub. I was voted into that match. And for that, Leaving, I am forever grateful. I am indeed. Look, Billy, it doesn't get more special than that night for me. That's the start of the story and the end of the story.
So we're looking forward for FPWA now, Power Pro. It was at that night of in December 2023. It was the first ever Power Pro event officially. But we're looking at Dawn of Power, March 10th at Truth Nightclub. You've got a very, again, you're I don't want to say fortunate. I think that would be very dismissive of the work you put in. But you're put in a position, you're in the semi-final of a tournament to determine the first ever Power Pro heavyweight champion in a match with Tommy Cartel, who again you've scuffled with quite a number of times over the last couple of years. And then the winner will face either Andy Roberts, who you've come up short with against already, or and I apologize to the person, is it Niwa? Is it NIWA? I don't know how to say their name. Apologies. But that's gonna be, if you get past Tommy Cartel, if and when, I don't want to absolute that, because I know Tommy Cartel will be in touch. That's a big night. Dawn of Power, March 10th. Is this your goal? Is this the work you're putting in between now and March 10th? Is it just all building towards that night?
Ba 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 da ba da ba da ba da. You ever heard what's that Frank Sinatra song? That's the beginning. Can't remember what it's called. When I think about that song, I think grandeur. And that's what springs to mind when I think about Dawn of Power. Billy, you've hit on some incredibly valid points there. It's not lost on me that once again, I've been quite fortunate being part of this tournament. I don't take it lightly, but what I have to put out into the universe is this question. What would the world be like with Frank as the champ. Can you imagine? It would be fantastic! But at the end of the day, it's not going to be an easy feat. Step into the ring with the coach again would be a real honor. Real honor. Real honor. Tongue twisted. Tongue tied. And that would be the dream scenario for me, Billy. Because I feel like I was quite close the last time we met in the ring. Nothing but respect. Nothing but respect. Nothing but respect for the boss. I just feel like I would like to prove myself, you know. But look, we're only a matter of weeks away.
We are. What happens. And the match cards get stacked and stacked and stacked as the days go. It's gonna be a big night for Power Pro. I'd say this is their first official. It's Dawn of Power. I guess this is the first landmark of Power Pro going forward. It's a promotion that.
Yeah.
In 1 hour, I don't know if you've seen our awards went out tonight as of recording, and Power Pro is the one to watch promotion for this year, voted by the SWN listeners. This is the promotion to watch, and to possibly see yourself, or I mean, even if it is Tommy, we don't want to focus on the negative here, but to see someone who's homegrown through Power Pro lift that title would be certainly a mark of intent for the promotion going forward, to see what you can do, what you can achieve by heading to Power Pro.
Billy, I feel like the SWN audience who cast their votes are a compassionate, considerate, intelligent people, clearly. Look, Power Pro is my home promotion. So it runs through my veins to hear plaudits, praise being heaped upon the promotion. It means the world to me. It means everything to me. It means so much. So that's really pleasant to hear.
So we'll move on to our questions that we've got through Instagram.
Yes.
Well, do you want to answer them first? Or do you want to answer our two questions we ask everyone on the podcast? I don't know if you've listened to any in the past, but we have two of the most ridiculous questions that this will be the penultimate time they'll be asked. The season 7, they're gone. The questions will be removed from the question set. So for the last time officially, I'll be asking you, because I've already recorded the next episode, do you want them first?
Yes, let's do this. Yes! So, I'm ready.
So for the actual final time for me saying it, what's your favorite dinosaur?
Dinosaur.
And I'll forever love this question, just for that kind of reaction where you think it's gonna be a wrestling question. It's gonna be the best wrestling question ever. No, it's a dinosaur.
I would have to say the Parasaurolophus. If I'm pronouncing that correctly. Because what an interesting head crest.
Have a look at it. Oh, of course. How could I forget what a Parasaurolophus this is? Even though I can't see it. Well, there's a little thing on Google that you can actually click.
Structure, atypical of the other dinosaurs from that period, I believe.
Duck build. There is a button that I could press to find out how it was called, but I've changed my headphones to do that, so I won't do that. So, we'll just assume that we're both right. Fantastic answer.
But Billy!
Yes?
I've got a question for you, my friend. Okay. In the same vein, perhaps. What's your favourite member of the Mustelid family? Eh?
The what?
I'm talking martens, otters. I'm talking ferrets. I'm talking weasels. I'm talking stoats.
Ah, all right, okay. I didn't know, realize there was a collective family for them. Well, I've known a few weasels in my time, but
yeah.
A couple ferrets. You mentioned otters.
No, Billy, come on, we're talking about animals here.
Oh, there are animals, absolutely. But I would have to go otter. How can you not love an animal that holds Indeed. Their respective partner's hand as they float, so they don't float away from each other? How can you not appreciate that beauty as a species that they have the wherewithal to do that? And they like to be like have their head stroked. I've seen the videos of them requesting humans to give them a wee tap on the head and everything. It's otters are just a beautiful. I don't want to read anything more about otters just in case it turns out they're really horrible creatures. But from what I've seen and what I've heard, they're beautiful.
I'm with you. Listen, I think that was a good answer. I think they are one of the top three mustelids.
Now I got to know what the other two are.
Well, it's all a matter of opinion. And just like wrestling, I suppose it's subjective. I would say my favourite would be a mink or a stoat. Maybe they're the same thing. I don't know. I just don't know, Billy.
Yeah, I've got a couple of minks in my time as well. what a beautiful language.
Well, I think you're maybe applying a colloquial terminology when we're talking about the genus, the species.
I think that's where I'm getting mixed up because I'm sure I've seen some minks at wrestling as well. But we'll move on.
Whoa!
God, it's the second last episode of the season. I'm just getting all the old guns out, shooting cowboy. So another question we ask everyone is, what would win the fight? Two sheep or one cow?
Sheep!
Correct.
One's holding. Yeah.
I don't need the workings. I know you're right. It's sheep. Everyone who says cow is just incorrect. You've between this, the robe, the houseboat robe situation, the otters and two sheep. We're getting on like a house of fire, Frank. This has been a wonderful
Absolutely. Trip. Maybe we could be co-hosts. We could perhaps create a brand new show. I think you and I have got Gorilla Monsoon, Bobby Heenan type chemistry, or Hall and Oates, somebody like that.
Simon and Garfunkel. Got it.
Simon Garfunkel. Struggling to think of another duo. But listen, I think we're unique. I think we could be something completely new, different. I've got a pitch to make. Maybe we need to chat after this is over. Eh?
Let's do this. Let's do that. So let's get into Instagram. For
Insta.
Some of the most interesting questions you may ever hear. I mean, notwithstanding the two you just heard. We'll start with the kind of nice little easy in kind of questions with the mini meat machine. I think it trains at Power Pro.
Yes!
Kind of selling on our question from talking about the wrestling side of things. It's just asked, do you think you're going to win the Power Pro Championship?
I'm going to try. Yeah. It's going to be all effort. I'll tell you that much.
That's all you can do at the end of the day, and I can't wait to get the results in. Like the old, I think they still
Billy,
do it now.
You need to be there.
I wish I could. I'm at the point of my life now with a young child where I like my own bed at night and like to make sure that I see him in the morning. It's just, I'll give it time. You win that belt, hold it for a year, and I'll see you. That's the challenge. You keep hold that belt, and I'll see you.
You're a good man.
Let's see what else we've got there. We've got James Blair, old school cool. He's put in capitals. Is he, I would shout it, but again, illness, I don't want to do that and ruin my throat. Is he old school as old school cool? And where did he get that robe?
The robe. Let's answer that bit first. I acquired that from Papua New Guinea. And that's all I'm going to say about it.
Fair enough.
And the other part of the question, sorry, Billy, what was the other part of the question again?
Is he as cool Is he old school? Is old school cool?
Does a good cook cook good cookies? If they cook good cookies, how many cookies does that good cook cook? It's in that same vein. And I think the answer is going to elude us.
I do want to note for James Blair that when I put out these questions for other guests, he's offered them a battering. He's offered them a square go. He didn't do that for you. So I don't know if James Blair maybe maybe he's a little bit intimidated by Frank Gallo.
No need to be. I think he seems like a smart enough guy. I like that question. Good for him. Thank you.
Speaking of the robe, we mentioned Bret Hart being an inspiration. Not known for wearing a robe, but more the leather jacket kind of thing. Was there an inspiration for the robe when he saw it in Papua New Guinea? Was it a Rick Rude? Was it a Ric Flair? Was it a Greg the Hammer Valentine? What was the inspiration behind seeing that robe and thinking that's it, that's part of the ensemble?
Where inspiration comes in boxes, ceramic tile warehouse. Do you get that in Aberdeen? That advert? No? Listen, I don't know. But if I consider the inspiration behind the robe, well, the robe in its purest form in wrestling, let's rewind. Luthes, I believe, wore a similar robe. There have been many ornate and opulent robes throughout the history of wrestling. I can't just pinpoint one. My robe in the New Guinea situation really didn't have anything to do with the overall robe influence. I just acquired it there. So, to answer your question, it's likely an amalgam of many of the favourite wrestlers of mine over the years. The whole thing. Put in a big ball. What? Put in my pocket. Save it for later. Like push pop.
Oh, push pop. What? Well, that's a throwback.
Save some for later.
We've got Taylor Bryden asking. So Taylor Bryden, W3L heavyweight champion as of recording, and hopefully as of going out, because I don't think they've got a show between now and this episode going out. That's really bad luck if he loses it. You should just ask, do you have a favourite Japanese wrestler of all time?
Billy, this is an interesting one, because are we talking about an ethnically Japanese wrestler, or are we talking about people who maybe made their name in Japan? Maybe we can discuss both.
Maybe.
A few spring to mind. People like Tenryu. Obviously, you've got the classics like Misawa-san. We have people like Bruiser Brody, Stan Hansen. Big influences on me. Made their names in Japan. Non-Japanese. But that's all right. It makes sense that we maybe mention them in this conversation. Hiroshi Tanahashi. Here's another. There's a lot. Kawada. Look, we could go on and on and on. But there's some fantastic wrestlers from particular periods of time that I feel slightly drawn to. But,
Each their own. Absolutely. As we've learned, as we've discussed, wrestling is subjective. It's a case of one's favourite doesn't necessarily have to be yours, which is indeed. Okay. PK Master Govan, he's asked a bunch of questions. We could probably quick fire them. I'm very interested in the last one, just kind of a nerd. So quick fire, three questions. Best wrestler in AEW?
All Elite Wrestling, look, it'll be, is that Dr. Pepper, Billy?
That's it, I'm ill. I need to get the doctor on board. Not sponsored.
So Mr. Do you remember that?
The line cut out for a second there.
So misunderstood, Dr. Pepper. Greatest. So misunderstood. AEW, All Elite Wrestling. So, it's probably no surprise that I'm going to mention someone with maybe older school tendencies than maybe others. I don't know. Dustin Rhodes. I like Dustin Rhodes. Samoa Joe.
I was
fantastic
surprised.
Wrestlers.
I thought we were going to get a box. Danielson, maybe, just because your Bret Hart side of things, you're skewing there for a bit of Danielson. Mox for a bit of that Japanese wild side things with your Brodies and what have you. There's a good crop to pick and choose from.
Indeed. Agreed. Listen, you get no disagreement from me.
The next question, similar vein from PK Master Coven, best wrestler in TNA. So I see you as a PCO guy. I don't know why I see you as a PCO guy.
Well, I'm a big Quebecer guy. However, let's consider one of our own. I think we'd be remiss if we didn't mention Joe Hendry.
Check my windows. Because if you say his name, he does appear.
I believe he does. I think it's important to mention Joe. I think it's important to mention... let's think about the heavyweights. Like, let's talk about Moose. Moose! Moose! Loose. About where, Billy?
This house.
Not in this house. Not in Methyl Docks, I'll tell you. Not much for not much. Ha!
Past guest of the show, a past guest of the podcast, Moose.
Fantastic.
Yeah, plug and Joe Hendry as well. He's been on the show as well. So you're joining quite a cast of names in the world of this podcast with the likes of Moose and Joe Hendry and whoever else I've been able
Indeed.
To nab for 45 minutes to an hour. The last question got from PK Master Govan. I'm interested to see how this goes. Best Pokemon.
Sorry?
Best Pokemon.
Slimer!
There's going to be one listener who's going to be very happy with that answer, so we'll just move on from here.
That's
it! So, we've got three more questions. We'll leave the brain-breaking one for the end from Ian Skinner, because I hate they ask this question every time, and I still don't understand it. We've got Brad Attitude. He's asked, what match that you've had would you say you've enjoyed the most, and your dream match?
That's difficult. Although, there's a couple that spring to mind. I have to say, Twas a Night of the Wrestling 2, part 2, part 2. Myself and the coach, myself and Andy Roberts. Yes. Yeah. That's got to be it.
And the dream match, is it the rematch for the title?
You put the words in my mouth, Billy. And they were the right words. Yes.
So the dream may come true. Yes. The story may be finished on March 10th. If you haven't got tickets already, get to Dawn of Power leaving at Truth March 10th. You know, there's your plug for the show as well.
Yeah.
People start thinking I'm a professional. We've got Westy asking, if you were in charge of any wrestling promotion in the UK for a day, what would your ideal show, match, stipulation, and opponent be, and why? You're pretty much, you're getting carte blanche, you're getting a blank check here. You get to pick everything for yourself. So it says opponent, but we'll say opponents if you want to throw a couple your way, if you want to do a fife way, if you want to get the old big blue bar cage out for a multi-man. Just you've make them alive, but what's your throw money, money's no object situation.
Wow. Wow! The very thought that I would be entrusted with that kind of power would be somewhat unsettling, Billy. Let me think. The thing is, there are so many promotions in the UK, in Scotland specifically, that I've not been able to rear my ugly head at yet. So, I need to probably stay homegrown. And I'll say, there's Power Pro, being a Power Pro G. And what we'll do is we'll do a match that originated in Power Pro as well. Or maybe didn't originate there. Maybe it was dreamt up somewhere else. Maybe it was, maybe it wasn't. It's the Methil Power Station Memorial match. Yeah. And I'll maybe choose as an opponent, a dream opponent now. Billy, are we talking about just a wee second, are we talking about wrestlers of the distant past? Are we talking about current wrestlers? Are we talking about...
I feel like as long as they're alive, that we'd be okay.
Okay.
So, like, yeah. it's possible to book.
Bob Backlund.
Bet you can still go.
Yeah.
There.
I don't fancy my chances, but listen, I could learn a lot from that man. We could all learn a lot from that man. So I'm going to go with beautiful Bobby Backlund. Fantastic.
Methil Station Memorial Match. Yes. Opponents, James Ellis, Bob Backlund. Oh.
James Ellis. Fantastic wrestler. Champion in his own right.
And the last question that we've got, Ed, before we do that, though, because I regularly forget to do this, and I should do it more, how are your testicles? It's a very leading question. Well, I'll qualify that by saying, if you go to manscaped.com, you can pick up a new set. The 4.0 has just come out now, where you can just get everything groomed. It looks like this. It's very nice. You can use for other things. 20% off manscaped.com. Go there, SWN Scotland, get free delivery as well. Now I've just bamboozled Frank with an advert. And
No. Listen, I'm stunned because I feel like that device you just showed me would be night and day compared to the straight razor I've been using for the last while. So
it is a very lovely
Manscaped, perhaps give old Uncle Frank a wee promotional freebie. Eh? Manscaped. Hit me up, baby.
Yeah. If there's a man they need to represent Manscaped, it's definitely going to be Frank Gallo. Because at the moment, my head looks like what is down below because of Manscaped. Anywho, with that being said,
well done.
The last question is the best I've ever.
Congratulations.
It's the best one I've done so far. Ian Skinner has asked, we're all ready for this. Everyone knows what the question is if they've listened to the past podcasts. Would you rather have unlimited bacon but no more video games, or games, unlimited games but no more games?
Unlimited bacon.
I know, I'm gonna have to do the follow up questions because I know Ian will ask me to. But what about unlimited games? There's unlimited games but no games.
Bacon.
Yeah, that's the best way to sum that up there. Ian, you're going to continue asking that question, and I'm going to continue asking it because I'm a very respectful host.
You're lovely. Fantastic, guys. Ian Skinner.
But you will continue to break my brain every time you ask it. So just know,
Bacon.
Ian, you kill a little bit of my soul with that question, I guess, asked. Anyway, so as far as Scottish wrestling goes, before we wrap up our chat for the evening, you've got keeping your lot of promotions. You've been seeing some wrestlers come and go through Power Pro. Is there anyone that you're looking at just now going, oh, I can do some magic with you? You'd maybe get old Frank in the ring with Judas Grey, and we'll make some magic. Is there anyone on your immediate wish list that you've got?
There are fantastic wrestlers scattered across this country. Maybe not scattered, concentrated all over. There are great wrestlers I've run across on my somewhat limited travel so far. I look at a guy like Caleb Valhalla, fantastic wrestler, fantastic fellow. Although I feel like him and I might get on better in tandem and combination. There are a lot of names in FPWA/Power Pro who I would love to wrestle. Perhaps too many to name. We've got people like Tommy Cartel, and of course, him and I are going to lock horns shortly, my boy. We have people like, Talon Jr., very talented, if I do say so myself. We have people like Hunter Samson, he's a gigantic man. We have people like Zachary Swift. These are all the local guys in my home promotion. But then I look further afield. And then I consider people I've maybe stepped in the ring with in the past. I was in the ring with Casino Brutal. They filled my head in one night. But fantastic. And I feel like if I was to get together with them in a local British Legion, we'd get on fantastically well. And then I think about people like Arcade Violence. I see maybe naming tag teams here. These are people I've stepped in the ring with and thought, good grief. Wouldn't like to meet these boys in a dark alley. However, like them. Fantastic, talented wrestlers. I had a brief interaction with Aspen Faith in the Disco Derby. He knocked a few lumps out of me. Again, there's so much talent. I feel like I'm missing too many people. I'd love to step in the ring with Ryan Richards again. Thatcher Wright. People that I've already wrestled. Others. There are loads.
I suppose at your stage in your wrestling career, it's a case of just getting the experience in, getting everyone you can, and then once you're 20 years in, you can look back and go, okay, I haven't faced this guy yet, I haven't faced that guy, but I want to face this guy again. It's about building that experience. And as far as your journey so far has gone, you've been picking up those experiences every month, and new places, new experiences, new opponents. So it's going to be a very exciting year for 2024 for Frank Gallo, because by the time this goes out, we'll be looking at, 5 weeks away, possibly, from seeing you become the first ever Power Pro heavyweight champion. So it's going to be a very interesting time for old Frank.
Indeed, 2024 could be a fantastic year for Frank. And my only hope is that I can continue to mix and mingle across Scotland. And, who knows where the wind will blow.
So before we wrap up then, where can people find out more about Frank Gallo if they want to? Of course, not the years between 1992 and 2019. If they want to find out in the future more about Frank Gallo, where can they?
That's at, isn't it? At the Frank Gallo. On the net.
Right, we'll tag you and stuff. It'll be all right. I'll confuse you for a moment, but we'll tag you and stuff. Don't worry. But perfect. This
is on the World Wide Web.
On the interweb. I'll link it. Don't worry, it's fine. So before we go, this has been an absolutely fantastic chat. I'm glad that we've been able to set this up and we've been able to get this done because, like I say, it was a little bit delayed due to myself. We've hung on. We've made it. I'm going to go to bed now. That's probably my next port of call. But in the meantime, this has been an absolute blast and a joy to watch. So if anyone's wanting to see Frank Gallo, March 10th is your next bet. We'll make sure you become Power Pro champion. But again, thank you very much for joining me.
Thank you. Thanks.